Hi and welcome back. Today I am going to show you how to design an internal spur gear using SolidWorks 2022. By watching this SolidWorks tutorial, you will learn the technique of 3D CAD designing of an internal gear like a professional. By watching this tutorial, you will learn the use of SolidWorks feature tools like Boss Extrude, Revolve Cut, Extrude Cut, etc. Hope you will stay connected with us and continue learning advanced part modeling by SolidWorks 2022. Hope you will love the way we design the internal spur gear by using SolidWorks 2022. So, let's get started. Click on New Part. First select plain white from the Apply Scene option. First, click on the front plane and start the sketch. Take circle command and draw circles like me. The outer circle diameter is 85 millimeters. The inner circle diameter is 65 millimeters. Let's extrude this sketch. Extrude depth is 25 millimeters. Let's add some color. Use matte steel. Nice. Go to the option, Document Properties, Image Quality. Select High Quality for the best image quality. Now we gonna remove some material from the outer surface of the internal gear. For doing that, start a new sketch on the right plane. Draw construction a line like me. Take convert entities commands and convert this edge into a line. Draw one more construction line like me. The distance between these lines is 35 millimeters. Take line command and draw a profile like me. Make them collinear. These two lines too. The length of this line is 1 millimeter. This one 3 millimeters. This one 8 millimeters. This one is 2 millimeters. This one is 2 millimeters. Change it into 3 millimeters. The distance between these two lines is 3 millimeters. Here the distance is 1 millimeter. Height is 1 millimeter. This one is also 1 millimeter. The sketch is fully defined and ready for Revolve Cut. Select the revolution axis. Press OK to complete the command. Press the space button and select isometric view. Apply 1 mm, 45 degree chamfer on these edges. On this edge too. On this edge too. One millimeter fillet on this corner. Finally, 0.5 millimeters and 45 degree chamfer on these edges. Press the space button and select isometric view. Start a new sketch on this face. Draw a circle of 68 millimeters in diameter. Extrude cut 0.5 millimeters. Same on this face. The diameter is 68 millimeters. Extrude depth is 0.5 millimeters. Now we gonna create the teeth of the gear. Sketch on the surface. Draw a construction line connecting the origin and the vertex of the circle. Convert these edges into circles. Draw lines like me. The exact distance between these points is 2.5 millimeters. This distance is 5.5 millimeters. This distance is 3.2 millimeters. This distance is 1.5 millimeters. The sketch is fully defined. Trim unwanted lines. Take extrude cut command. Select through all. Press OK to complete the command. Press the space button and select isometric view. Use the circular pattern command. Use this face for pattern direction. Select extrude cut 3 as the pattern feature. Pattern instances are 24. Press the space button and select isometric view. Now we will remove some material from the gear teeth. Start new sketch on the right plane. Start section view. Take line command and draw a profile like me. This distance is 32 millimeters. This distance is 7 millimeters. The length of the arm is 13 millimeters. This one is 7 millimeters. Delete this relation. The projected length of this arm is 3 millimeters. Don't need the dimension of this arm. Draw a construction line like me. Convert this circle into a line. Convert into a construction line. This construction line is required for using dimension. This distance is 0.5 millimeters. The sketch is fully defined. Use the Revolve Cut command. Revolve about this axis. Press the space button and select isometric view. Turn off the section view. Perfect. Congratulations. This is the final gear, what we were trying to build using SolidWorks 2022. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you are watching this video on Facebook, please like and share. Because your engagement encourages me to upload new tutorials. Please also let me know your thought about this tutorial through comments. Thanks for your time.